Hi, good morning everyone. Okay, so today we will learn a new chapter, Learning Unit 5 for PRM 1016, Mathematics 1, Matrices and Systems of Linear Equation. So my name is Madam Liana Binti Truna. Okay, we will cover 4 subtopics for this LU5. First one is matrices. And then second one is determinant of matrices, and then inverse matrices, and the last one, 5.4, system of linear equations with 3 variables. Okay, at the end of this subtopic, you should be able to perform operation on matrices such as addition, subtraction, scalar multiplication, and multiplication of 2 matrices. And then you will learn how to find the transpose of a matrix. What is a matrix? A matrix is made up of rows and columns. So a matrix is just a rectangular array of numbers arranged in rows and columns enclosed by a pair of brackets, such as, for example, this one and this one. The numbers in the matrix are called the elements of the matrix. Dimension of matrix. The size of matrix is described by the number of rows and columns it has. Okay, the first matrix has 3 rows and 3 columns. We call this one as 3x3 matrix. And then the second matrix has 3 rows and 2 columns. So we call it as 3x2 matrix. Okay. Number 3 here stands for the number of rows. Okay, 3 rows. And number 2 here stands for the number of columns. So 2 columns. Okay. Don't forget the number of rows first, and then followed by the number of columns. So a matrix with m rows and n columns is called a matrix in order m/n. Multiply here, we pronounce it as by m/n. Okay, let's try example 1. Find the order of the matrices below. Okay, given that matrix A. Okay, so the order for matrix A. Matrix A has 2 rows and 3 columns. Okay, so it is 2x3 matrix. The order is 2x3 matrix. And matrix B, it has 3 rows and 2 columns. So the order is 3x2 matrix. And for matrix C, it has 2 rows and 1 column only. So 1 column only. So it is 2x1 matrix. And for matrix D, it has 1 row and 2 columns. So it is 1x2 matrix. Okay, next, a matrix notation. A general 3x3 matrix is written as matrix A, where the subscripts attached to each element refer first to its row and second to its column. So here we can see that this one, what we call subscript of the element. Okay. An element in the I row and J column of a matrix A represented by Aij. Okay. For example, A12. So 1 here refer to its row, so row number 1, and 2 here refer to its column, so column number 2. Okay. So A12 located at row number 1 and column number 2. Okay, next we move to the types of matrices. The first type we will look at is called a square matrix, a matrix with an equal numbers of rows and columns. Okay, for example, 3 is a square matrix of order 1 by 1. Okay, and then 1, 2, 3, 4 is a square matrix of order 2 by 2. Okay, and then followed by 3 by 3, 4 by 4, and so on. Okay, so that one, what we call square matrix. And then next, zero matrix, a matrix of any size where each element of the matrix is equivalent to zero. Okay, for example, you can see here, number 3, all the elements equal to 0, 0, 0. It is called 0, 2 by 2 matrix, and is denoted by 0. Okay, next is diagonal matrix. All its elements, except those of the leading diagonal, are zeros. Okay, so this is an example of diagonal matrix. Okay, what is leading diagonal? The leading diagonal of a square matrix running from the upper left entry to the lower right entry. Okay, so the leading diagonals start from here until here. Okay, so next, identity matrix, or capital I. Each element on the leading diagonal of a diagonal matrix is 1. Yes, that is the definition of an identity matrix. This is an identity matrix, and this is also an identity matrix. So what do you notice looking at them? We can see that the elements along the diagonal are 1, and the rest of the elements are equal to 0. Okay, next, row and column matrices. As the name suggests, it is a matrix with just one row and one column. Okay, so these are the example of row matrices. Okay, and these are the example of column matrices, only one row and one column. Okay, number 6 is upper and lower triangular matrices. Okay, upper triangular matrix, where the elements below the leading diagonal are zeros, and for the lower triangular matrix, it is vice versa from the upper triangular matrices, where the elements above the leading diagonal are zeros. Okay, and then last type of matrices is equal matrices. Okay, two matrices are equal if they have the same order and if corresponding elements are equal. So you can see here, matrix A equal to matrix B. So all the elements inside the matrix A is equivalent to the elements of matrix B. Okay, so these are the 7 main types of matrices we need to know before we begin with operations on matrices. Okay, let's try exercise 1. Okay, find the value of x and y for these matrices. Okay, actually this one is the equal matrix, so you just compare left hand side matrix to the right hand side matrix. Okay, so you just compare directly, x equal to 2 and y equal to negative 5. Okay, and then for part B, you just compare both sides. Okay, make sure same position, x equal to 3 and y equal to 0. Okay, okay, next let's try solve exercise 2 together. Okay, given that the matrix A, okay, and you need to state what is A22 and A31. Actually, this one, okay, is the subscript of the matrix. Okay, so A22 located at row number 2 and column number 2. So overlap here, and A22 equal to 0. Okay, and then for A31, okay, A31 located at row number 3, okay, and column number 1. Okay, so overlap here, number 9, A31 equal to 9. Okay, and then you need to find the leading diagonal of matrix A. So leading diagonal of matrix A start from 5 to 6. Okay, 5, 0, 6. Okay, so the leading diagonal is 5, 0, 6. And then next, find the order of matrix A. So this one is 3 by 3 matrix, 3 rows and 3 columns.